Defense manufacturers have bright future. Without thinking about you, without thinking about the defense manufacturing, without thinking about the self-reliance in defense sector, the country cannot make any forward step. This is a very important thing. So it's a compulsive thing for the governments in future to think about the defense manufacturing. So DIIA has selected such a subject. Such a subject, any future thinking without the defense aspect, defense self-reliance, it is impossible. So DIIA's working is in the working in the critical area. This is a very important thing, this is what I want to make. The second important thing is, it is not just manufacturing of the low-level things. What I made important point is, the self-reliance in the critical things. It is not just low-level things, or least technology-centric, but high-end technologies. It is a critical thing which is going to give us the leadership. When we aspire to become the part of the global leadership, I am not saying leading the whole world as a leader, but even if you want to have a less ambitious desire, drive, that you want to become part of the global leadership, then global leadership will never come without having at least such level, threshold level, or such a kind of stamina to participate in that global security system. It is not possible to become a club member. So this is a very important thing. So in coming days, definitely I would like to restate any government. I am not just because BJP National General Secretary and the BJP happened to be the governing party. It is not because I am saying, but because any government, any party ruling, they cannot forego this. They have to think about. And the story of the world cannot be written without the, you know, thinking about India. So India is the leader or important captain for the growth story or any kind of world which we are going to think about or which we are going to write about. This I want to make it. Now, second important point, the expansion, the level of security systems we have to develop. Largest military, one of the important. Largest military, and we have paramilitary. And we have in the federal system, police forces, combining together, what is the requirement? Not only that, we have the investments outside, we have the stakes outside to protect our assets. We are creating assets outside. Not just within the domain of Indian frontiers. We are creating our assets outside. So, protecting our assets outside becomes a job. When I say assets, it is a physical assets and also it is a political assets. It is not just confined to physical assets. It is extended to the political assets which we have got maybe in Africa, maybe in South Asia, maybe in the Southeast Asia in coming days. So it will be getting extended. We have to understand this. So the architecture of security has to incorporate all these aspects. And this requires any policy or any framework which you create, this requires the internal support system and internal capacity building. Without building the capacities and all these things, you cannot maintain the support, the ecosystem or framework. So this is very important in all these aspects. Now, defense manufacturing is very important. So, Make in India, when Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi has declared on September 25th, 2014, it is not just Make in India, it is in tourism, it is the other areas, but the critical aspect of the Make in India is in defense. Unless it becomes success story, then Make in India cannot be called as a success story. This is a very important thing. In this, what is Indian defense? Today, it is completely dominated. Definitely defense sector, whenever, whichever the country, it is a government procurement domain. Government, you have to supply to the government. Military means you are supplying to the government. Any country. So governments are very important factors in the export market and in the domestic market. But in India, when we say in coming days, if you want to create a self-reliant defense sector, definitely partnership models have to be created. I'm not just talking about hand-holding. Hand-holding is a very restrained word. I'm talking about in order to make India as a player at the global level, as a club member, India as a competent player in order to protect its physical assets globally and its political assets globally, then you need to create a different formulations. So my appeal to DIIA, please be bold. You need not be politically correct. You should be correct in shaping the destiny of the country. Longer, it is not five years bandwidth you have. You have the 20-25 years bandwidth. Political governments and political leaders are always, I have got the constraints, to work in the 5 years bandwidth. They have to go to the people in a democratic country. But DIIA has no compulsion. So while making a debate, the demand on the government, we have to keep the long-term interest in view. The long-term interest is partnership. So the formulations have to be very bold. It is not just incremental. Because the ambition is not incremental. The drive should not be incremental. So we need entrepreneurs. And we need crop of entrepreneurs. Not one, two exceptional entrepreneurs. We need entrepreneurs. And in order to supply to the kind of requirement, we need to create powerful, vibrant defense clusters. Without thinking of powerful defense clusters, it is not possible to make India a player at the global level. A supplier not just for the domestic. We have an internal interest. It is not that commercially we want to, as a warmonger. It is not the issue. Even to avoid wars, you need to supply the arms. It is a deterrent force. So export market is a very important thing. So domestic and export, for this, you require a different partnerships. So defense cluster is a very important thing. Second thing, definitely MSMEs. Ultimately, the powerhouse in India is MSME. It is not large companies. It is globally also not large companies. But definitely, compared to the global experience, Indian experience, even for the next 25 years, it will be the MSME story. Even in order to evolve the large captains among the MSMEs, MSMEs have a role in its evolution. So in this, MSMEs, what is the critical aspect? The critical aspect is the finance. The critical aspect is the credit. Unless we create a special vehicle, it is not possible to create a robust MSME for the defense system. You are expecting the MSME to access the loan at the rate of interest, what kind of rate of interest, and they become a player. And they become a global competitors. It is impossible. We have such kind of experiences. In agriculture sector or in a small sector, in the micro enterprise sector, there is a priority lending RBI as they experience and it has experimented. So if we take defense is a very important thing for the survival of the country or to satisfy the needs of the ambitions of the country, then you have to accept it as a mission. Mission of the nation, not mission of the sector. MSME should not be seen as an interest element or interest part. We have to take it as a national interest. So in this context, we have to think. Shri P has the experience. Shri P has the experience of, and it has got the exposure of this kind of lending, 84,000 crores and so. So in this, we have to come with the formulation that we have to create a special fund to satisfy the needs of the finance, particularly this kind of electronics and defense sector, small scale industries. So this is an important formulation. I'm not getting into the details what kind of situation today, whether the government is able or not. If we are, what we are going to demand need not be accepted by within 2 months or 6 months or 8 months or 1 year. We need to create an opinion and we need to create a drive. Today this MSME is now contributing 2 lakh jobs directly, 6 lakh jobs indirectly. And when we are thinking about meeting our needs domestically, then in coming years per annum, this sector is capable of creating additional jobs, 1 lakh, 1 lakh 20,000 or more. We are. So we can take the responsibility and we are ready to share the burden of the government in creating the employment for the young people. Definitely, this we have to. So this is an investment for the government. And this is not just investment for the entrepreneur, it is an investment for the government to reap or to harvest the benefit. So these are the things we need. And technologies. Technologies, there are different ways. Technology transfer is not very easy happening in the defense area. It's not that countries which hold the key will be interested or delighted to transfer the technology. It is not very easy, particularly in the security system. So in this, what kind of partnerships are enabling partnerships to make this technology transfer a realizable objective? Technology transfer is very important. So in terms of finance or in terms of the technology transfer, if a single unit is not capable, then creating the consortiums, creating the groups, creating the platforms, these kind of formulations have to be tested. And in this also, government and PSUs have to play a lead role or partnership role. It's not just sympathetic relationship is not going to become acceptable in the next one decade. It's a partnership model which we need to create. Another point I want to add is a skill area. Hyderabad is a very important area, for example, Bangalore or Delhi or Pune, all these are very important. Where so many research labs are there, so many electronics or defense related centers are there. Fortunately, we have good educational ecosystem, institutions are there. But are they aligned to the required skills? So we have to think about in terms of alignment of this skill curriculum. Unless we create that kind of alignment, in coming days, engineering colleges are no more useful for this particular purpose. They may be there on paper, they may be there giving certificates. But we require a different alignment. So this alignment has to be worked out, and particularly in the defense clusters, we have to work out. Unless we create that kind of an alignment in terms of skill, it is not possible. Now, DPP 2016 manual, all these things they have explained. I'm not going to get into the details. But what I want to say is, everything is there. Here, in the inaugural session, what I need to speak? What is in the formulation? What is the amendment and what is the change? What is the offset ratio? What is this? All these things. All these things are dynamic. Amenable to change. Change in the interest of the domestic players. But the important thing is DIIA consolidation. Opinion building. All formulations are subject to change in favor of us. And in coming days, they have to, they will be. Whenever I meet defense minister, whenever I meet any defense policy expert, I discuss. Even when I was not in BJP, I used to meet. And I know, when DIIA has invited the government here, the state government, which is not ruled by BJP, of course, it is away and out of India. So it shows DIIA is not politically linked with any political party, but it is linked to the cause and the mission. I am also interested in that, because the national issues cannot be tackled by aligning with one political party. Consensus is required. Honorable Prime Minister, when he said on national issues, the Team India or cooperative federalism, all these things, they say same thing. So, in my view, in coming days, this kind of conferences and this kind of deliberations are going to help and are going to create a kind of opinion which is required to share the policy, force the government, and also enhance their confidence. The leaders of the government, their confidence also will be enhanced by these kind of deliberations. And I am happy, once again, I am thankful to Ashok Atluviji and Tyagiji for inviting me as the guest in the inaugural session. I have a great hope, and I also have the faith that DIIA is an exclusive organization. We have a number of organizations, platform organizations, that are ready to serve everybody. But this is an exclusive organization to focus on the needs of the defense manufacturers or defense innovators. So, this exclusive organization will take active interest and engage all the stakeholders, including governments, and will be successful in formulating the future defense for framework of India, and world future is